These problems of angles of elevation and depression are the exciting, when in the world am I ever going to use this kind of problems. This takes the trigonometry that you've learned about and applies it to actual real-world problems that we've really had to solve. The angle of depression, the second video, is a real-life problem my husband asked me about, and I was able to solve it with trigonometry. I want you to get out your worksheet, the angles and elevation and depression worksheet, and on the back side, I want you to find number 5. So find number 5 on your worksheet. Pause the video, get out the worksheet, and find number 5. So a guy wire is attached 30 feet from the top of the 100-foot tower. So I've got a 100-foot tower here, and a guy wire is attached 30 feet down from the top. One of the reasons I'm doing this problem is students always ask what a guy wire is. Guy wire helps brace a tall, skinny thing like a radio tower or something so that it doesn't blow over in the wind. It helps make the tower more sturdy because of the properties of trigonometry. To continue on, the guy wire makes a 55-degree angle with the ground. And the question is, what's the length of the wire? So I'll call the guy wire X, or the length of the guy wire X. From the angle here, the things I know, the distance I know, is the opposite. I can figure out how high up that guy wire is attached to the radio tower or tower. And the thing I want to know is the hypotenuse here. So if I'm working with an angle with the opposite and the hypotenuse, the function is going to be sine. So the sine of 55 is going to be the opposite length of the distance up that triangle makes. The opposite length is 70 feet because the full tower is 100 feet. The wire is attached 30 feet down. That makes the distance from the ground to where the wire is attached 70 feet. So the sine of 55 equals the opposite, which is 70, over the hypotenuse, which is X. Now it's been suggested to turn this into a proportion. Makes it much easier to solve if you think of it as a proportion. So I can say the sine of 55 over 1 equals the opposite over the hypotenuse. So pause the video now and do your cross multiplying. Multiply, as I would say, in an X. Pause the video and work out that multiplication problem. Okay, when I multiplied, I got that X times the sine of 55 equals 70 times 1, so it's 70. Now I want to solve for X, so I'm going to do what on both sides? I'm going to divide both sides by the sine of 55. Sorry, my 5 got a little goofy there. Running out of room. Simplifying, I get that X equals 70 divided by the sine of 55. At this point, I pick up my calculator and do the calculations. Pause the video right now. You get your calculator and run the numbers, see what you get. On my calculator, I get that X equals 85.45427, etc. So I'm going to say to the tenths place, my final answer is that the length of the guy wire is 85.5, and the unit is feet. So here's one example of how trigonometry actually helps us figure out real-life problems that we want to solve. Enjoy this, move on to the angle of depression video, and have fun with these actual problems.